Gracious God, on that night so long ago, your son continued his move toward the cross, wrapping a towel around his waist, kneeling to wash the dirt from the feet of his friends as his betrayers loomed and the powers that oppressed his way pressed in. Tonight we gather to share in the heritage of our faith, the saving drama of Passover, and to celebrate Jesus' last meal with his close friends, remembering the cross's coming. But so too is the resurrection. Amen.
They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took with him Peter. distressed and agitated. And he said to them, I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake. And going a little further, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said, Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I want, but what you want. He came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, Are you still sleeping, taking your rest? Enough! The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand.
I follow that this cup has brought.
My Father.
was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he's calling for Elijah." And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, and put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down." Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this man was God's son."
Underneath me, all when Jesus gathered with his disciples for the final time in his earthly ministry, he knew that that was going to be the first of many for the disciples who had been following him for 3 years. They had an extraordinary intimacy. They had shared their lives together as brothers. They had been first-hand witnesses to the extraordinary miracles he had performed, and miracles in the obvious and not so obvious ways. They had a first-hand experience and observation of the events that had taken place in that final week. They were with him at the beginning of the week as he wept, as he looked over Jerusalem, because he said, if you had recognized even this day the things that lead to peace. They had observed the difference between his procession, the procession of a peasant followed by peasants from the east, and the procession on the west, the Roman military empire, and the stark contrast between the two. They had witnessed him being questioned by the various temple leaders as he taught in the temple courts throughout that week. After all they had seen, what all they had observed, what all they had experienced, he knew that they still didn't get it. He knew that in just a few hours, he too would come into the time of trial. He knew what they did not yet know, that even in their commitment, even in their confidence that they would follow him wherever it would lead, that they would be disappointed even in themselves. He knew that they wouldn't live up to their own expectations. We know that we don't live up to our own expectations. We know that despite our attempts, our devotion, there's still so much of it that we just don't get. It's still so mysterious to us. We fail ourselves, and we know we don't live up to the mandatum, the Maundy Thursday commandment, to love one another as God in Christ loves us. And yet we are called to remember, to remember, to remember that nothing will ever separate us from God's love, to draw strength from that love, to draw strength from one another. We need it today just as those first disciples needed it 2,000 years ago. And so on that night, in that upper room with his disciples, Jesus took a loaf of bread. And after he'd given thanks, he broke it. And he said, take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance. Remember me. And in the same way, he took the cup also. He said, this cup is the new and eternal covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you partake of it in remembrance. Remember each one of you, all of you collectively. Remember me. These are the gifts of God for each and every one of us, the children of God. Thanks be to God. I invite you to come forward to receive the elements, and in the way of order, so we don't turn into chaos, I'm going to invite you to come to the center aisle, and we'll begin with the front row. Then after you receive communion, you can exit and go back around to the outside. We have some offering plates placed here for your convenience, and all of your offerings, for those of you who came prepared to do that, and oftentimes I forget, so there's no shame in that, but all of this goes to the summer nutrition program. I invite you to come forward as you're able. For those of you who can't, we'll be mindful and watching and make sure that we're able to serve you where you sit.
Peace that comes.